Hello, basketball fans. Great matchup for you tonight between the Connecticut Huskies and the Illinois Fighting Illini. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
We have a couple of true point guards running their team tonight, and they're running the show. This will be a treat for any basketball fan.
Tonight should be a good one, as we've got two excellent centers that'll be battling it out down low. Number 40 is the great leader out on the floor for his team.
The player who'll be guarding tonight is also a tremendous leader, Brad. This has potential to be one of the great matchups of the year, baby.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. I think we're ready for the tip.
And the first half is underway, baby.
They're working around the perimeter. Here comes the ball screen. 10 on the shot clock. He's all alone. Nails the jumper.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
Here's a nice face up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job. Face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
Kicks it out. 10 on the shot clock. Goes. Pushes it up.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
Goes up for two. Up and in.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
Kicks it out. For two. The lane. Brown receives the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
A little two-man action. They work the perimeter.
Frustration right there.
Here they go into the break.
That's a basket off the break, baby.
Looking for a good shot. From the baseline. Knocked it down.
Trying to go inside.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
The quick shots, Brad. That's why the tempo meter is where it's at.
On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the jumper. And it's in and out. They'll work it around the arc. Left of the circle. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, they'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
On the outside, he attempts the jump shot. Busts the jumper. Count's getting high. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Up and in. Now they work it around the perimeter. The lane. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Cross court.
Great anticipation defensively.
Brown receives the ball. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Coach wanting them to set up defensively now. Moving it around the perimeter. Turns it over. Now in transition. The center takes the feed. Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
Hey, they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
For the bucket. Up and in. Working it around the perimeter. Ten seconds to get a shot off. He tries to beat the buzzer, and it's no good from three-point range. Goes up for two. The layup. Both teams looking to get things going here. They're working around the perimeter. The skip pass is picked off.
Pass is stolen.
Terrific gamble on the interception. This team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
That's a foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad, before the game, both coaches and players said they were looking forward to tonight's matchup. Whose weaknesses will be exposed and who will really step up, guys?
That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. Eludes the trap there.
Dump it inside.
For two. Perfectly executed. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
Can't get the shot to go. Tries the three ball. Comes up short. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Dick, was he there in time or not?
Oh, you betcha.
McBride looks to record his first miss.
He provides nice push offensively and defensively for this bunch.
And momentary look from three-point land with a little baby hook. The Huskies have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Pushes it up. Tries for two. Up and in. Boone handles the feed. He shoots from right of the circle. Busts the J. bucket. And off the mark. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
That's exactly what I was thinking, Brad. The pace of this game has been remarkable.
Number 50 gets the pass. Goes up for two. The Huskies have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brady's on fire.
For two. The layup. Gordon handles the pass. Gave it up. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Kicks it out. Sorts of time. He misses the tray. Well, let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
The center with the ball. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Perfectly executed.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He goes up with it. Off the mark. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries for two. Dick, it's really been a while since I've seen a team shoot like this.
Hey, every once in a while you'll get a squad that gets on a tear and simply makes your jaw drop. It's fun to watch, isn't it, Brad?
Beyond the arc. He doesn't get the hoop. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Guys, if you haven't noticed, the coaches want the ball being pushed up the court. The tempo doesn't seem to be at a speed which is conducive to their style of play. Let's see how the players on the court react and make changes moving forward.
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. For the bucket. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
Kicks it out. He pulls up with a jumper. They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Brad?
If only my knees weren't aching. Boone handles the feed.
Up and inside.
Hammers at home.
Take a look right here. He explodes to the basket.
Full court pass. Goes up for two. Up and in.
Take a look right here.
Looking for a good shot.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Missed it. Gordon handles the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
It's even more important they don't have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For two, the lay-in. Head receives the ball. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper cleans the glass.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Brown handles the feed on the outside. With the jumper. Nails the jumper. Well, I think the coach is going to have to make some changes here, Dick. The players are starting to look really tired out there.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, if you have great post play, you got a chance really to win.
Cross court. A deep shot from outside. No. At the end of the first half, the Fighting Illini trail by nine. Well, let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Well, we're halfway through the contest, Mr. Vitale. What about those points of emphasis of yours?
These guys could be doing a better job with the points of emphasis we brought up during the pregame. They're not doing the things that make them successful. And I'm certain their coaches have been discussing this with the players.
It's all about doing what you do well, isn't it, Dick? It's such a simple concept. Let's see how these guys do in the second half. Williams checks back into the ballgame.
Yeah, I knew they couldn't leave him out for too long.
Dick, we're heading into the second half in our player matchup. It's going about the way we thought it would.
Well, they're really doing a great job. Both guys getting good shots, really making them count, and really their teammates are getting them the ball at the right time.
At least you make the highlights letting them do that.
Illinois is just getting punished in the rebounding department, Dick.
Hey, Brad, how many times have we heard that if you want to win basketball games, you have to control the glass? These guys know that. They better start getting the job done.
They're working around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Good for two.
Defense extended here all game long. There's that pressure on the ball. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. In and out. Gave it up. Good job defensively. Boone receives the pass. Inside for two. Can't get the shot to go. Dumps it in. He shoots from the top of the key. Scores it. They work the perimeter. 10 seconds to shoot. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass up. With the J. The missed shot. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Boone handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. Tan on the shot clock. Tries for two. Up and in. Head handles the feed. Here comes the ball screen for the bucket. The layup. Work it around the arc. Takes the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Goes up for two. Doesn't go. On the outside. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability. It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Now looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, the two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporated into their scheme because it works. Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
For two, perfectly executed. That's going to be a backcourt violation, Dick.
Hey, the defense did their job, baby.
Number three set to record his first action.
Hey, this guy will give you a great hustle on the defensive end of the floor.
McBride handles the feed. Trying to pack it inside. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Ten seconds left on the shot clock. He shoots from left of the circle, knocks it down.
What a great touch. Good baseline drive, squared his body. Well, here comes some pressure.
Puts up the tray. It won't fall. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Kicks it out. They get an open look for three. The Fighting Illini have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Gordon handles the feed. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Williams handles the pass. He makes the block. the jumper. For the bucket. The shot won't fall. Pushes it up. Turnaround jumper. They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
That's worth another look.
The power forward with the ball. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
10 on the shot clock. Gave it up. For two. Up and in. On the dribble, gives it up. The Fighting Illini might be in some trouble here, Dick. They're going to have to put the pedal to the metal and really look to attack offensively to get some baskets.
Hey, ultra-aggressive is the word that comes to mind, Brad. Their backs are against the wall, and they'll have to maximize their effort and pace of play to wipe out this deficit.
He gets the foul, and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
Boone pops back into the ballgame after a well-deserved rest.
Wow, he makes such an impact on his team when he's in the game. At both ends of the court, Brad.
He gets it to go. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, in regards to our player matchup, the coaching staff has expected it to be evenly matched up across the board all night long. But you wonder, who's going to be the first one to throw the punch?
Thanks, Aaron. Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
Trying to feed inside. Tries for two. The land. So we get another look. Moving it around the perimeter. Fake. Three. Gets it to go. Gave it up. He tries the jumper. A lot of people can't hit that shot anymore, Dick. That 10-12 foot shot.
Yeah, the medium range shot is an extension.
With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
He can't get any more open than that. He drills the long-range bomb. Working it around the perimeter. For the bucket. And in and out. Goes up for two. And he missed. Off the rim and no good. the dribble, gives it up. He could not get more wide open.
They let him get into a rhythm.
They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. He misses the J, blocks the shot, and the ball goes out of play. Armstrong comes in for his first go-around tonight, Dick.
I'll tell you, the offense doesn't miss a beat when this guy comes in.
Lots of room. And he hits the three. Boone receives the ball.
Up and inside.
Takes away the pass. Here they go in transition. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Launches away. And he misses the shot. Anderson handles the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
No good. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Ten on the shot clock. For two, up and in. 9 points is the difference now.
A difference that can change in a heartbeat if you ain't careful, Brad. I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, or their timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Ball coming in from the sideline. He commits his final foul of the afternoon.
Hard fought game, though.
They're set to throw it in from the side. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
Sideline inbounds. A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
He goes to the line. Sinks it. Short, long, doesn't matter, doesn't go. Timeout. Well, Dick, execution coming out of a timeout is really important, wouldn't you say?
Definitely, Brad. The play you call or defense you decide to run coming out of a timeout could make or break you. Good coaches will always ensure that their teams are clear on the expectations coming out of a timeout.
Ball's coming from the sideline. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
The point guard with the ball. He shoots from the top of the key.
The Fighting Illini to find a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brad, he's on fire.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes it! Second one is no good. They want to talk about it right here, Dick.
They got to find a way to chip into this lead before it's too late.
Dick, what do you do with a 7-point lead?
Hey, they keep playing and continue to do what's gotten them this far, Brad. Can't change now.
They look to get it to the inside. Fakes the shot. Tries for two. The Fighting Illini have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Illini
like to play that up-tempo style, Dick. What allows teams like them to play that style?
Up-tempo teams typically have some great athletes, people that can really get out in transition, who really can run exceptionally well, and also can jump exceptionally well.
Well, Dick, another one's in the books. Any final thoughts about the keys we had coming into this game?
Well, Brad, the points of emphasis provide some valuable hints, suggestions, which can and should result in a better team performance. Achieving them may not always result in a win, but it does make winning more likely.
Teams are so diverse these days. They play all different styles, and it's a matter of knowing your personnel, primarily their strengths and weaknesses. Illinois couldn't come together quickly enough tonight as they lose this close one.
They'll be disappointed to come up short to such an evenly matched team.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.